Hello, I am your host with the most, The Chronic Toast, and it has been some time since we have last been on an adventure together. It's been a number of years, actually. And so what we're going through right now is largely just trying to get the rust knocked off, not only of YouTube videos, so to speak, but also of, well, just doing any sort of simulation trucking or any other things like that. Right now, just trying to struggle through some audio issues on older equipment. We'll get that upgraded at some point. And I figured I'd walk through just some of the settings that we have right now. So I've got a European Truck Simulator 2 currently set up. We've got all of the available DLC as far as functional, playable DLC. Some of the paint packs have come over as well, just due to some of the bundles. But as far as trying to get everything set up and places to go, travel, loads to pick up, we should have everything here now. I have played a lot of American Truck Simulator in the past, as you guys have watched probably some of my older videos, but definitely this will be my first time playing European Truck Simulator 2, and I'm pretty stoked about it. There's definitely some discrepancies between both games. A lot of things are, of course, in European measurements, so metric system, you know, centigrade, kilograms, liters, things like that. So we're going to go through just a few of my settings here. Very, very basic. Audio settings right off the bat. I've got everything turned down here. Trying to balance the audio so that I can utilize a single source of audio recording rather than separating it out. We'll see if I regret that later, but usually in the past it's worked out well. Got the music down. Sound effects are all set up as per normal. Controls, I am, in fact, using the keyboard plus the Logitech driving Force GT wheel. That's what I have right now. I don't have a separate H-pattern shifter, so what that means is I'm using the sequential shifter that is on the unit itself. I also don't have a clutch, so I'll be using the automatic clutch, which has worked out pretty good. And one of these years, I'll probably upgrade. But as far as graphic settings, nothing too crazy right now. Still rocking 1920 by 1080 default refresh. 100% scaling. Most everything is on high, ultra, or medium. I am still running a 970 4GB card, the Pip-Boy edition, pretty much the creme de la creme of the GeForce 970 series cards. So again, it runs everything I need to run just fine right now, including recording. This game is a bit of a hog regardless of what you have for hardware. So we'll see how far we get along with this, and we'll go from there. If you're going to take a look at the world map, you're probably wondering where I'm actually starting out. So that's right, I'm starting out in a place that I'll probably mispronounce the name, Stavanger. I could have started in a number of other places. UK was appealing, you know, somewhere near Birmingham or Sheffield, but that is also one of the older parts of the maps, and as many people have stated, it's done to death on YouTube, so to speak. I'm excited to get down here into any of this stuff. I've never been into this region before, so I'm excited to see what the world looks like through the eyes of this game in particular. And for anyone out there that happens to be watching this either at the tail end of 2018, throughout 2019, or beyond, if you have any comments on what would be a cool place to see, just comment below either on this video or any other videos that happen to be in the playlist. So I picked Stavanger. Again, I could be mispronouncing that. Just because it seemed to be a unique area, I can work my way down all the way through Sweden, down through all the regions down here, and check out a lot of cool places. That's the goal. And I have a friend from high school that lives in a town not too far from Stavanger. So I figured, you know what? It'd be an interesting place to check out, and we can go from there. So right now, I have the Iveco selected as the starting truck. The reason for that is not because I think it's the best, not necessarily because it's the most ideal, but quite possibly because everyone has said it is the absolute worst starting vehicle. So, you know, I figure I might as well be up for a challenge. We'll see what happens. We'll be taking a number of quick jobs, trying out different vehicles and trucks, and try to work our way up to buying our first vehicle. And my goal is to have local AI trying to be the local drivers for the first you know, garage that I opened up for my company. But definitely, in as opposed to what I've done in my American Truck Simulator playthrough, where I'm assuming I'm a company driver, I'm going to be trying to go down the road of getting my own trailer and taking some interesting jobs as we go through. So speaking of interesting jobs, we'll load in here. We're starting in a quarry, which I haven't ever done before, which is pretty exciting. Try to get the camera here for the truck figured out in a way that works. So we're taking what looks like a one track from a giant digger or dozer or most possibly a crane. And we'll work our way out of here. Absolutely beautiful as far as European Truck Simulator goes. There's a lot of more amazing games out there, but this one does a really, really good job of what it's capable of and presents it rather well, from what I can tell. Let's see if we can get back inside here. Alright, so I am running Track IR Pro. Still have a little bit of work to do on the actual profile of it to make sure it's a bit more smooth, but as for everything, let's try to get going here, get the e-brake taken off, and we'll see what we can do. Try to find our way out of here. I think we have to go all the way around, so we'll see. Yeah, these shorter trucks, these snub-nosed trucks, are pretty cool. It's definitely not something that I'm used to. I'm still used to, as much as you can be used to, not having played for a couple of years. The longer W900 and W900L trucks and truck mods from American Truck Simulator. So we'll see what happens. Definitely, I'll have to get used to the differences in speeds, kilometers versus miles per hour, things like that. I have to watch my RPMs here. One thing that I will say about the Iveco, and I think this is the Stratolus or Stralis, I'll have to look, it could just be the Stralis. Other than being underpowered, which all things considered, I'm willing to take a challenge, as long as it's not more than 30 tons for this particular configuration, from what I've been told. It's hard to see the, it's definitely hard to see the RPM gauge down there. Not necessarily the RPM gauge. Kilometers an hour, the speedometer, so to speak, to see what you're doing. Let's just take it easy here. I already picked up the wrong gears. Yeah. These trucks having a snub nose, or it's flat, I seem to always misjudge a little bit the the turning radius. It's amazing just how well these things go get along. Just try to knock the rust off. There's a lot of it. Just be warned. We'll be having to get our bearings here and work through all of this, and as well as trying to get up to speed on the latest YouTube challenges, as well as technical issues for audio. Things like that of that nature. So what have you guys been up to? We're here on Christmas Eve, just about ready to roll over to the 25th here in the year 2018. As I'm recording this, figured I'd finally have some time to sit down and go through this whole adventure here. We'll be trying a few different things as we go through, namely, you know, talking when it's appropriate, potentially trying to go through and you know, just give some silence here and there, just to let you gals and dudes enjoy the ride. I think I've got the automatic retarder on. I don't know, I haven't really ever messed with that too much. I know in American Truck Simulator, I think I accidentally turned that on and was stranded on the side of the road until I figured out what setting I accidentally messed with on the keyboard. I gotta keep watching the RPMs down here. I don't know if this is a 13 speed or if it's an 18 speed. I have a suspicion it's an 18 speed based on what we're doing. We're definitely not within the the ideal fuel efficient zone. You can see that down there in green, whereas the red is the overrev. It's actually a really cool idea, so you can see where you're most fuel efficient. A lot of the American trucks, at least in the American Truck Simulator, by default in the game, don't have that listed at all. Trailer seems to be pulling just fine back there. I didn't quite check to see what the weight was. We are doing a solid 55 kilometers an hour, which is not super amazing fast, all things considered, but on a small dirt road with a small little truck, it's working out pretty well. So I can keep it on the road. Start applying some brake. I did turn down the braking sensitivity, and I'll probably have to turn that down just a little bit more. Just because I feel that what's in-game is it's just a little bit too aggressive, too sensitive, especially if you don't have any trailer load behind you at all. It seems like when you're in that particular situation, the truck just stops on a dime, and I just don't think that's fairly realistic. But again, this is a bog standard version of ETS2 right now, and one thing that we'll be messing with as we move forward, especially here, probably after these first handful of videos, as we getting the rust knocked off and getting back to the group, is I'd like to find the winter mod, at least for aesthetics, possibly for the physics portion of it, but definitely the aesthetics. It is winter right now, and we are up north here in the game, and relatively up north-ish in real life, more than that. And I figured it'd be a nice change of pace, just to kind of get into the season, a little bit festive, and then as summer rolls around, we'll switch over back to the default summer stuff. I have no idea how far we have to go. I did look at the map earlier, and it seems like we got to go down south and around, which kind of looks like what we're doing. We're doing 80, which is the speed limit. I don't have the speed limiter on right now, simply because I don't know what it's set at, and if it's region-specific or country-specific, or what. If there's country-specific requirements, then we can set it. I'd like to set it for Finland, and then anywhere we go beyond that, that's what we're stuck with. Again, I'm not quite sure how that works in the European Union or the adjacent countries, but I do know that in the States, like if you're driving out of California, for example, if your speed limiter is set at 50, and you go to a different state, you don't get to change it on the fly. So, roads here are quite a bit, tighter, it looks like. Let's keep that in mind. I was not expecting that. Golly, this is really, really tight. I don't know if that's... I'm assuming it's based on reality of some sort, but... Wow, there is not much room. You'd figure over here in the States there's enough room to get trailers and heavy equipment through, and over here... just not really seeing that be the case. A little bit of culture shock, I guess you could say. But again, got to focus to keep it on the road here. But yeah, we'll see what we can roll in as far as mods. I know for a lot of the American Truck Simulator stuff, Jazzy Cat has a lot of mods. There's a lot of really cool mods like longer yellow lights and all that, which for ATS are very, very realistic in terms of bringing a bit more simulation back into the game. I'm not sure what's going to be necessary or needed here for this particular game, but got to do a little bit of research, and if anyone of you gals or gents or anywhere in between have any suggestions on what actually, oh that's cool, but what actually would make this a bit more realistic, especially for Finland, Sweden, and surrounding countries, I am all ears. That'd be very, very cool. I get used to these. I'm assuming that's a yield sign. Let's see. One thing I know is I'm pretty sure that there are no rights on red here. like there are in the States. That could be country specific, but pretty sure that is the case. So we'll see. See how that goes. Man, it just feels so good to be back into this game. Even if I am absolutely over-revving the crap out of this and just getting used to this all over again. So the bog standard stock Iveco, I think, is 300 horsepower, something like that. Roundabouts are still a somewhat foreign concept, so we'll have to do some research on that, as well as take it easy. Let's watch for other people that are either following the rules of the road or not. Either way, defensive driving is where it's at. This is only 50. See, it's really hard to see down there what the actual... speed limit is. That's cool. Got your little overrun here for the trailers. It's just so foreign to check all this out. It's pretty cool. Yeah, as I was saying earlier, you know, just let me know what you guys, gals, are all up to, and if any of y'all have some suggestions on what I should do, places to go, either based on cool things here in game, or just based on cool things in real life to see if they do exist in game, let me know. And for anyone that's ever driven truck, or just driven in general over in Europe, if you have any recommendations, give me a holler. We're going to have a whole string of these episodes coming out, and hopefully we'll work through the audio issues, graphics issues, and just generally get a better experience, all things considered. Just not only for myself, but for you all as the viewers. I have no idea what any of that is. NS2, some sort of oil? NS oil. I guess that makes sense. Let's see. Where did... Oh, this is the place. Oh, I just killed it. Sorry, buddy. Try not to clip any signs. Alright, where do they want it? Let's see how many gears are in this thing. Put the parking brake on. Only 12. Wow. I guess they are shorter gears, all things considered. So they don't have quite as much top speed, maybe? Let's see, where do you want it? Just right there, huh? Well, let's give it a shot. This is not going to be pretty, but we'll see what we can do. I've already messed it up. Goal is one, to not jack pick. Two, to swing it around to the point where we can just back this thing in. See if the theory meets with reality. Oh, I have to mess with the... Well, the mirrors on this thing for sure. Because the field of view is just junk. I think if we cut it hard enough, I think we'll be okay. Then we can just get in there somewhat straight, pull up, and get it going where we need to go. So let's see if I can remember how to do this. This is literally the first time I've been driving in this, folks. So it'll be a fun adventure. Banks are still a little touchy. See, are we even anywhere close? Actually, not bad. Wow. That was unexpected. Well, let's see if we can get it somewhat close or if we just absolutely hose it up. Clear on that side, clear on both sides. Coming in a little bit cattywampus. That's alright, let's get that back end over. Probably gonna run out of room, we'll see. Well, golly. If it works, it works, eh? Let's go take a look at this before we just decouple. Yeah, this is a Iveco Highway. Huh. Golly gee whiz, this is pretty cool. Well, let's decouple here and see what we got. Excellent. 120 kilometers, 3 hours 29 minutes. Fuel consumed 60 liters. I gotta figure out the conversion on that. I know liters are less gallons. That's not true. I mean, really, really dumb, but I'm pretty sure that's the case, and it's generally more expensive than the comparative amount of fuel just because of the region, the amount of fuel, availability, and all that. But base reward, 120 kilometers, 2,200 euro, 120 XP. I don't think that's pounds. Again, if I'm misspeaking, let me know in the comments below. Oh, man. Cool. Well, level zero, still a newbie. Let's see what we got here. Monday, 1329 CAST. Oh, that's right. We get our headquarters. It looks very oddly similar to the ones over at ATS. Pretty basic garage. May not be much, but it is a start. Still don't have a truck yet. So we'll go through that process. Good luck. Cool. Well, let's go see what's in the job market. Go from there. I'm going to try to do everything out of here. That's all I can do right now, but I want to stay close to home until I get a truck. So DAF XF-105, I've heard is pretty cool. There's the Iveco Stralis. Oh, so it was a Stralis Highway. Cool. 580 horsepower. Wow. Scanias, a lot of people love those. Volvo, don't know much about those. Renault trucks, they look cool. They got those weird headlights up top. European truck stuff is just a foreign concept to me. There's a lot of rules and regulations for why the trucks are the way they are compared to a lot of your longer haul American trucks. If you recall back, a lot of the American trucks back in the 60s and 70s that were flat nose or snub nose, similar design, that was again driven by regulations and requirements. Generally, they're considered less safe because whatever hits your front bumper is also hitting windshield at the same time. But, you know, you're trying to maximize the amount of cargo that you can actually haul with the vehicle. And so you do what you have to do. Let's see, Iveco, Scania, Mercedes. I don't know. They're just really, really cool. So we'll have to get out and do a bunch of driving on these. And we'll see how that goes. See, I just love the boxier look. That's pretty darn cool. I'm sure there are other manufacturers in here, potentially. I just don't necessarily see them. So, we got a DAF, 480 Superspace, 480 Superspace. It's an XF versus an XF-105. 340 kilowatts at the wheel, 355. Okay. Where is this going? Oh, it's going all the way to the other town. Is there anything that's staying locally? We don't want to go over a pile of ferries quite yet. approve international travel, so we're good to go. Okay, that looks like it's here in town. That is the Scani R normal roof. 450 horsepower, 331 kilowatts, 12 speeds, yeah. Let's take that one here to round out this episode and we'll see how it goes. Pet food. Probably should have looked at that. 657 euros, I think. Oh, see, this looks really nice inside. I'm sure some of these have different upgraded patterns. Got a reading light in the bed back there. Got a nice little moonroof or sunroof. Look at all those mirrors. That's cool. So you can see RPMs. A little bit different speedo. Taco, you can see there's good. Oh, that looks cool. What do we even, let's see what we look like here. Polaris lines. Oh, that's a sharp looking truck. That's not bad. Let's see where we gotta go. So we'll get out. And we'll head up here. Through some roundabouts. Left, left, left. One, two, three. Three roundabouts. Cool. Alright, well let's kick this off here and see what we think about this one. Sounds pretty good. Make sure the parking brake is on. Nice. That sounds really good. Sound like outside. Alright, well I'm not fooling around. Let's get out of here, guys. See if we can't figure out what we're doing. Oh, there is no GPS in here. Interesting. Well, we'll turn this on for now. I'm pretty sure with accessories, once you get your own truck, you are able to at least get one attached to the dash if you need it. So. Oh, cool. So this came off the ferry. See, that's a foreign concept as well. I haven't ever been on a vehicle ferry. I've seen them around here and there for going across places like the Great Lakes and such. You know, Wisconsin to Minnesota, or Wisconsin to Michigan, usually on the western and southern portion. But I think we might be going the wrong way. I hope no one is watching. And we'll get on the right side of the road here. Let's call it good. How about that? That blue spot. Are you sure it is? Shift point? Don't know. Oh, that's cool. It's got a fuel temperature, air pressure, your gear. Cool. Oh man, that just sounds so good. Slow down here. Yield. Golly gee whiz, dude. Nope. It's not gonna happen. Oh, there's a caravan. Trailer. You guys are the worst. I gotta figure these out. I'm just gonna go. Ideally, you're supposed to slow, not cut anyone off, but a little perplexed there's not any dual lane markers there either. Let's see. So let's see, can we see what the speed is? 40 and 60, so we'll gap it. Oh, this just sounds so good. cool. Make sure our trailer doesn't run over any signs.
Whoa.
And power. Find a better gear. I'm going the wrong way. Sorry, guys. There we go. I'm going the other way. Gotta get used to the way that I've got the sequential shifter set up. I'll have to go and see what I've done previously in American Truck, and probably just stick with that. That way, when I do switch back and forth, I'm not causing problems. That would be a huge bummer. Ideally, if we got an H-pattern shifter where we could go through all the gears and then possibly a splitter up top, where you're splitting on the low end or the high end, that'd be a lot more ideal. But I think for the long haul, that'll be a good plan, but for the short term, we're not going to necessarily need to worry about that. Unless we're hauling some really heavy stuff with some very inadequate trucks, which is always a possibility. We were just here. The trailer is still here. Let's find out. Where do you want it? Our trailer is not still there. Alright. Let's see where you want it, man. Okay. We'll just play it safe. We're getting near the end of the video, so pull up here. But again, thank you guys and gals so much for sticking with me here as we meander through this crazy adventure of knocking off the rust, probably going through a whole pile of fails in the short term. And when it's all said and done, hopefully you'll enjoy coming along for the ride. Again, this is something I'm doing for fun, and if something comes out of it, great. And if not, hey, still had fun. So get out here and not click those buttons. There we go. They're good with it. They're good with it. Oh, listen to that. That's cool. And we'll decouple and see what happens. Cool. 25 kilometers, hour, 7 minutes. Base rewards. Hey, we're level 1. We're still a newbie, I think, but, you know, it is what it is. Alright, what do we want to stick in here? Different load types. I think I'm going to go with long distance. That way we can eventually get some longer stuff here. Then we'll go down to the high value and fragile. And I'm not so sure what eco driving. I think long term that's going to be beneficial, especially here in, you know, Europe and all that. But we're going to stick fairly locally as far as I can try to and unlock some of the local areas here in Finland and adjacent over in Sweden. So we'll stick with long distance driving to kind of cover that bill, and we'll go from there. Cool. Well, again, thank you very much for tagging along, hanging out, and stumbling through this with me again as we knock every bit of rust we can off. It's going to be a pretty big effort. I've got older, outdated equipment here for recording. I'm working through, and we'll try to get that working as best it can, as well as the audio, and just trying to have some fun. So thank you much, and as always, I'll see you guys next time.